Yes, Mzansi, welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and what a show it's been. We are talking about so much. There's so much emotion going on right now. We first revealed the fact that Zoe's going to be leaving us, and that was the saddest news ever, but then we had to balance it out and bring in the fact that we've got a new presenter on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and that is the one and only Carissa Cupido. So we thought, let's dive into exactly who she is, what she's about, and what makes her tick.
Oh, well, I feel like we all need to talk about radio background and how that helps you on a platform like this.
Yes.
You are with Good Hope FM.
I am.
How did your journey with Good Hope start?
Sure. Well, my career in radio started during varsity. I was doing a show at UCT Radio, which was really lovely. And straight out the bat, I just kind of refused to go into the workforce if it was not in line with my passion. So yes, I was balling on my parents' budget, making sure I'd get to varsity every day and put in the hours before Good Hope FM finally hit me up. I sent through my demo and thankfully they said yes. So that was my foot in the door when it comes to commercial radio. And I grinded, let me tell you. I did 1 to 4 in the morning for an entire year.
Whoa.
Mondays to Friday, plus, you know, slots in between standing in for people. So I really put in my 10,000 hours in the first year already. That was the start of it, and it's just been super great since then.
What are you covering, like, in terms of the topics? I know we all have, like, our certain archetypes that we can't steer too far away from, and it seems to become a valuable topic and a current topic in a lot of the conversations. What do you focus on, Monia? What like, really gets your passion box ticked?
In general?
Yeah.
Or on radio?
Well, both, actually. Both. On the show more, yeah.
Okay, so I really love pop culture. It's something that, I don't know, I just find so much escapism, entertainment, and also interest in it, because I love people. I love connecting with people. And whether that's somebody on the ground or somebody in the lights, it's always just really interesting to me. I also just love things to do with the culture. So whether it's music or streetwear or fashion, cool hairstyles and makeup and beauty, I'm definitely into all of the above. It might sound superficial, but I think that that's truly what sets my heart on fire. Also music. Yeah. I'm a big fan of music.
Yes,
another reason why I'm in radio, you know?
Yeah.
And I get to play that for people all the time, whether it's in my car or behind the mic.
Oh, well, see, that's why you're on the perfect show, because this show is literally a little bit of everything.
Exactly. Oh, you're going to love it.
Oh, we love it. Now, are you an outdoor person? I'm only asking because Ryle here is Mr. Nature Boy.
Yes.
Who's looking for hiking buddies? Are you a fan of the outdoors?
I love the outdoors. I'm a bit of an ambivert, so I definitely need time to myself to recover. But put me in a mountain, and I'm so happy. I have been on a hike with Ryle before. I don't know if he remembers
this.
A little while ago, it was a group of us with a brand, a company, and we went up and had such a great time. That was probably one of the harder hikes I've been on. But I'm definitely here for just kind of immersing myself in nature. They call it nature therapy, so
yes.
I get that.
It is that, but just stay clear away from me, because I will drag you into the depths of the mountain, into the highest peaks and beyond.
Can I tell you, I once went on a hike with him. He traumatized me. I think we met at like 5 a.m. or Hoppers 5.
Goodness.
It was like we left in the dark with headlamps.
Yeah.
Ended up climbing so high, we had to take the cable car back down. Like, we started in Newlands and had to take a cable car down. That's how far we hiked.
Was a tad bit ambitious.
Here's a question. Did he give you pancakes when you got to the top?
Yes, we did.
It was a
good pancakes.
Yeah.
We got pancakes.
That makes it worth it.
I was traumatized after that.
Have you taken call, though? He's been waiting.
Yeah, have you taken call, though?
Carl hasn't cracked the nod yet. No, he's still got some work to do.
You know what? I think he knows that he's met his match with me. We might jump off the mountain as well. Sitting, you know, but you know, amidst all of this, there's also been beautiful moments in your life as well.
Yeah.
And we saw a moment where you got, you know, received some flowers from a significant individual.
Yeah.
And we know that there was a proposal as well. We'd love to know just a little bit about that, because one thing you need to know about, you know, your Feel Good Breakfast Show is that we love getting involved in everybody's lives, not because we are inquisitive.
We love love.
There are no
but
boundaries.
We love love.
We love love.
And we love a bit of this. So talk to me about the proposal.
Oh my goodness. Well, the proposal, as you can see, it says POV or about to become a fiancé, because I had no idea that this was happening. So we were in Paris for work, and after the work was wrapped
sorry.
Up.
Casual. Sorry, wait.
Casual.
Just hold and slow it down when you say a detail like that again.
We were out in Paris for work. And once we wrapped all of that up, my man surprised me, which is very hard to do because I am nosy. I'm so bestio. I just know every detail of everything. But somehow he really caught me off guard. He booked this hot air balloon that overlooked the entire city of love. And up there, he asked me to be his forever.
Oh!
took a minute. I'm kidding. No. I said yes immediately. Of course, we've been together for a while, and he's my day one for real. So.
Oh, I love that. Oh, that's amazing. And I mean, look at the bling.
Bling. Okay.
Baby.
My eyes.
Wow.
That's like the whole of Kimberly on your finger.
It might just be the big hole.
No, congratulations.
Thank you so much. This is
amazing. I know that you not only are somebody who loves love as well, but you know, this hiking we've covered, this radio we've covered, and now, of course, there's a bit of running as well, right?
Oh,
You're a runner?
That's generous, but yes, I'll claim it. I'm a runner. No, I'm a jogger. I'm a casual runner.
Okay.
I know, Zoe, you've clocked 21Ks. That's something that I'm trying to do this year. I've done a couple of 10Ks and some fun 5Ks, and I'm really trying to put in the effort to clock 21Ks at one go sometime before 2024 ends. Running's hard.
How's it been so far? What's been happening?
It's hard every time, Ryle. Yeah. I wake up. I do look forward to it, but then when I'm out there, I'm like, Who sent me? Why am I doing this? But I love that that's part of the journey. It kind of pushes me beyond my limits, which is so inspiring to myself for just the everyday, because how you approach one thing is how you approach everything. Mm. So it's really just been the biggest test. And I think I'm passing.
So
I'm
all the footage.
I love how you document everything.
If you had more than one video of you running, you're a runner.
I think so. It's official.
It's official.
And you know what's really cool is that the fact that you're going to be hanging around on the show and chatting to some people that are going to inspire you beyond belief. Yeah. They're going to turn you into some type of a triathlete if you're not careful. So just be aware of the conversation that happens on your Feel Good Breakfast show. It is inspiring to say the least.
Mm-hmm. I'm looking forward to it.
We are also looking forward to having you be part of our family. And Wastey, I know that you want to get starting in the in the kitchen on some
Ben's
delicious
looking
soups.
Hungry.
You know, sometimes you know what we do sometimes in the show, right? Mm-hmm. We'll be mid-sentence and we'll just get up. It's crazy. Let me tell you something else.
And then he just leaves.
It happens.
That's how we do it. Oh, well, Carissa, we know that you're going to fit in so well here. You have everything that Espresso is all about. Mm. And I love that we will get to know you as the day goes by. So if you want to send some love to Carissa, she is joining our family. Send it via WhatsApp. Our number is 063-408-8863. That's a number you're going to have to learn and know at the top of your head.
I'm trying.
When people ask you for your number, you just give them 063-408-8863 if you don't want to give them your real number, but that is our real number, I promise.